What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to Team Seto. Today I bring to all of you the history of the dual terminal, from Raging Tempest to Maximum Crisis. Without further ado, let's start. In this story, we get introduced to Dark Terror Knight Batlamius. She is a new entity that contains light and darkness within herself. Dark Terror Knight Batlamius decides to fight against the Infernoid Tiara, which is the counterpart of the Goddess Sophia, Goddess of Rebirth, who intends to destroy everything. Batlamius is defeating Infernoid Tiara, but Tiara uses its last resort that consists of devouring the remains of the fallen Klee, and thus Tiara, Source of Destruction, is born. This new creature is part of Infernoid Tiara, the Apoglyphorth Towers and Apoglyphorth Skybase. Batlamius is no longer a rival to this new threat and succumbs to Tiara's devastating power. After the fight, Dark Terror Knight Batlamius loses one of her parts, Infernoid Decatron, which falls to the ground, releasing a spiritual beast Tamer Winda, who was imprisoned in one of the Infernoid Decatron jars. Winda is surprised to find her friends, Ritual Beast Tamer Sifru Wendy, Ritual Beast Tamer Sifru Pilica, Dance Princess of the Necros, Great Sorcerer of the Necros, and especially Ritual Beast Tamer Elder and Gusto Falco, after being separated for so many years. With the fall of Dark Terror Knight Batlamius, Spiritual Beast Tamer Winda and Falco Gusto have been released from the Shadow Curse. Another old friend appears, Ariel, Priestess of the Necros, who holds the Aqua Mirror Gishki and the Mirror Necros. It seems like everyone has forgotten the threat of Tiara, Source of Destruction, that has the desire to destroy all the races and create a new beginning. In order to be able for Shadow Sephrakor to face Tiara, he receives the power of all the Sephiroths, giving birth to Sephirotora Grammaton, the most powerful Sephiroth of them all. He is also a combination of all the dual terminal races. Sephirotora Grammaton is the last hope of the races that inhabit this world. Both giants are face to face and ready for the final fight that will determine the fate of this world. This fight is the most incredible in the history of the dual terminal, but this fight will have only one winner, Sephirotora Grammaton. Peace reigns again in the dual terminal world, and a miracle happened. Gemknight Lapis, which was a part of the Shadal construct, has come back to life and is returning to his home on the back of Gemknight Crystal, who has returned to his original form. He was the main part of Sephirotora Grammaton. They are being watched from the distance by Great Sorcerer of the Necros and Dance Princess of the Necros. Finally, in a corner of this scenario lies Gemknight Lazuli in its original form and goes to meet his best friend, Gemknight Lapis. This is the end of this war. But in a dual terminal war, the cycle of destruction and rebirth will always exist. Only time will tell the future wars and new races that will appear in this world. If you like the story, please make sure to subscribe, comment, share it and like it. Stay tuned. Until the next video, this has been your host, Team Seto.